Home, Ricky Smiley, Nonstop Jams, Robin Thicke in the building. How's it going?
Yes, 92Q, what's up?
Well, check it out.
Back.
I'm just checking out Me, I Play.
Yes.
You and Jay-Z.
Yes.
How was it working with him in the studio?
Oh, man, it was a dream come true. You know, I'm as big a Jay-Z fan as anybody. And he's always been a supporter of me and a friend to me. But we had never worked together yet, you know?
Right.
So, and I'd always been thinking, like, it's got to be the perfect record for Jay-Z. Like, I wouldn't send Jay nothing.
Right.
I was like, it's got to be perfect. Then I realized, you know what? Let me just play him the album before I finish it so he can feel the whole thing and see where he thinks he fits best.
Uh-huh.
So, Andre Harrell, my mentor, we invited Jay, and we set it up all night. We had his Ace of Spades champagne there. I had all these, you know, fresh chocolate-covered strawberries and all kinds of stuff for a Caesar that he is.
Right.
And then he came in, and I played him the album, and he loved the album, and then he really liked one of the songs that he thought it would be perfect to get on. He got on the song Me, I Play. But he said, I'm going to do it. He said, I'm going to write it over the next couple days, and then we'll set up some studio time. Half an hour after he left the studio, he goes, I got it. I wrote it. I want to do it tomorrow. So we set up the session for the next day. He came in. We had some of our friends there, some mutual friends that him and I have. We had some photographers. He was the one who goes, let's get some photographers, you know,
right.
and catch some of this history. And I was like, oh, this is ridiculous. I get to take pictures too? This is too cool. So he came in, and he was kind of pacing around in front of the speakers for a little bit, you know, getting his rap together, making sure he's got it the way he wants it. He's like, okay, I'm ready. He goes in there. He starts putting down the Miles Davis of rap behind the glass, you know, because to me, like, hearing his voice for 13 years that he's been rapping, or 12 years he's been rapping, it's so in my head.
Right.
As soon as he started rapping and I could see him right in front of me through the, and he's rapping on my song, I started jumping up on furniture like my champion, like my team won the championship. I was going crazy. I was like, Jay-Z's killing it on my song.
Did he do like one take?
Well, no, he does it in one take.
Oh.
But what he did was he would do one take, come in and listen to it, listen down, go, no, I know how I want to do it, and then just do another one take. But for him, he it has to be perfect, but it has to be flow. You know what I mean? It has
right.
to be like a freestyle flow. It has to be one flow. So
okay.
he would do it and then come back and check it out and then do it a full flow one time. But he didn't write no words down or nothing. He just had it all in his head. He's amazing, man. It's amazing.
Wow. We got Robin Thicke right here on 92Q.com. We got more with him in a minute.
Robin Thicke, 92Q.
Don't forget, of course, Robin's new album, Sex Therapy, in stores December 15th.
Yeah.
All right.
Right.
December 15th.
What a biscuit to go.
Thank you.